After dinner, the varied program of evening fun gets underway. If you feel lucky, maybe you'd like to play the horses. And your bet is as good as the next fellow's, for the speed of these horses depends neither breeding nor training, but on a charming lady and the cast of the dice.
Double. Four. Double. Five. And six.
Get the idea? Each time a horse's number, it takes a double or better to five. Jump a hurdle.
And double. Double. Six. One, two, and triple. Come on. Triple. Triple. Six. One, two, five, and a double. Double. Come on. Can't hear it. Double. Three.
Number three is the winner. There goes a happy young lady to cash in her tickets. And now, let's strike up the band. Everybody likes to dance. In this sparkling atmosphere, no one can be a wallflower. This is the Get Acquainted Dance, enlivened by a gay and colorful shower of balloons, and a jolly contest to add to the hilarity. The prize will go to the dancing partners who keep the balloons in place between their foreheads longest. No hands allowed. And if the balloon... Uh-oh, too bad. Thus, all too swiftly, it seems, the hours on the Queen slip by. Evenings filled with gaiety and good companion. Days of invigorating sport in the brisk salt air. Or lazy relaxation on the spacious decks. The horizon melts into the rolling hills of France. Almost before you know it, a berg are beside you, safely moored in the gangman. Now all the amazing machinery that services the ship goes into action. Even before passengers themselves are disembarked, their cars are swiftly brought up from deep down in the hold and swung ashore to be ready for the road to Paris, or Italy, or the Riviera. Travelers enthuse over this beautiful terminal at Cherbourg, one of the world's best and finest, with every convenience to make embarkation or landing easy and pleasant. Already waiting are the boat trains, and with simple customs and passport formalities completed, our friends will soon be off to gay Paris. But even while the boat trains are on their way to Paris, the Queen Elizabeth herself is underway again, crossing the English Channel to the port of Southampton. Soon, tugs are nosing alongside, and the Southampton Ocean Terminal looms close at hand. This new terminal is one of the few docks in the world big enough to accommodate the 80,000-ton Queen. Hundreds of people crowd the visitors or returning relatives. There'll be joyful memories and many a wistful moment, too, as our sparkling holiday at sea comes to an end.